In each episode of this series, I will offer an applicant a blind choice of either a pleasant experience, a treat, or a darker trick. They won't know which one they've chosen, and they may not know how or when it will happen to them. All the applicants responded to advertisements. These are the six people that I've selected. They just don't know it yet. Welcome to Trick or Treat. Tonight's applicant is Richard, a 20-year-old student from Wolverhampton. We've been observing him for the last few weeks to build up a profile and to monitor his movements to and from his flat. He lives a quiet and predictable life, which might be fun to shake up a bit. At 3 a.m. one morning in March, we've gathered outside his house, where he is hopefully asleep. His girlfriend has been persuaded to lend us a set of keys. I'm going to quietly break in and introduce myself.
Something nice. If you pick the one that says trick, it won't be.
Okay.
You won't know which one you've picked. You happy to play? Okay. You're going to sign this. Now it's a little bit too dark to read. It's a contract that allows us to do what we like with you. You need to sign that along the bottom there. I'll hold that for you. Thank you. Choose one of the two cards, Richard.
For Richard's trick, I'm going to have him collapse asleep in London and wake up 1,500 miles away in Morocco with no explanation. And for that, I'll need his passport. He will have no memory of the journey or of any time having passed. More of Richard's adventure later. Meanwhile, I've met up with the League of Gentlemen for a discussion about fate and mini-rolls.
Hello.
Hello there.
Hi, guys. Actually, would you grab a little chocolate roll from the trailer?
From here? And then, certainly. Yep.
There are five there, so if you can take one each, and if somebody can just put the last one in their pocket, that would be great. And come and sit down any chair that you like. Any one of these four.
Hello, and, how are you?
Steve, pleasure. Thank you, and Jeremy, nice to meet you. Have you got the last one that wasn't chosen? In your pocket, great. Keep that in there for the moment. Thank you very much. Well, look, thanks so much for coming out. Thanks for doing this. I want to show you these. There's four cards. There's something on the other side, but if you just mix them up for me, don't turn them over yet, and push them in the middle. If you can all just take one each, doesn't matter at the moment which one you take, but if you can just pull one towards you. On each card, there's a message, and I want you just to have a look and memorise now the message that you've got. Done that?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Great, lovely, and I'll have those back. Thank you very much. Excellent. Do any of you believe in fate at any level?
Yes.
Genuinely? I do. Yeah.
Yeah?
I think things happen because they're meant to happen.
I believe in some fates, but no other.
I believe that we create our own destiny.
Oh, you've got to come up with a different belief system now.
No, genuine.
I know, I'm trying to do comical answers to it, but I think I agree with Steve. I think you do. Your instinct often leads to exactly where you're meant to be.
You superstitious fools.
It's kind of about, it's about decisions, isn't it? And decisions that you make without sort of realising even that you're necessarily making decisions. And it's only in hindsight you go, that I suppose if I hadn't, you know, hadn't walked that way or gone to that party or met that person. A bit like, for example, the chairs that you sat in, I sort of made a point of saying sit in any chair, and I presume you weren't thinking particularly about which chair you were going to sit in before you sat down. Or the choice of the cards that you picked, which again, I told you not really to think about it and just take them. And they all had a message on. What was the message? What was your message?
It was a colour. It said, I will choose blue.
I will choose blue. Have you any idea what that refers to?
Blue's my favourite colour. I'm wearing a
blue
shirt.
You're wearing a blue shirt? Perfect.
The mini rolls are blue.
It actually doesn't refer to any of those things. It refers to a sheet of card that's underneath the cushion on your chair that you're sat on. And if you pull that out, you have to reach under the cushion.
Under the cushion?
Yeah. Da da da.
Look at that.
A blue sheet of card. And what did yours say, Mark?
I will choose green.
Pull it out.
And the card.
And it out. Very good. Jeremy, just to see where this is going. Jeremy, yours said
I will choose yellow.
That's right, take it out for me. Which leaves you with the red. Really.
Wow.
Excellent. So you see what I mean. Then they've got a decisions that aren't important, but you make them without thinking about it. And this is kind of an area that I find interesting. And it's also the good or bad consequences that you can avoid, or things that you never knew would have happened had you made different decisions. And this, for me, this goes back to, and this is why the chocolates actually do play a role. When I was about 10, I was in a supermarket queue with my mum, and she bought these, not these particular ones, but I was petitioning her to open them and eat them before we'd paid for them. And she was getting a bit angry with me, a bit stressed, and in her annoyance sort of ushered the lady behind us to come through ahead of us in the queue because she only had, you know, milk or something. And then we all paid for our stuff, and the woman went out, we went out. When we went out, there was a crowd that was gathered in the car park, and this woman who we'd allowed ahead of us had been hit by a car, and she was laying on the car park. And so at the age of 10, I'm then going home thinking, God, if I hadn't have wanted to tuck into those mini rolls, my mum wouldn't have let that woman go ahead, and would it have been my mum that got hit by the car? And you start to kind of do those things in your head. Hence the mini rolls. Would you, and carefully, if you don't mind, would you just open them and try not to break or touch the chocolate, and just sort of put them on the plates. Thank you. Lovely, thank you. And again, did you think about which ones you took? There were five altogether, weren't there? So you've got, Jeremy, the last one in your pocket. But otherwise than that, you just sort of grabbed. You just grabbed
random.
One. And you presume that they are indeed mini rolls.
They look like mini rolls.
They do, don't they?
It could be razor blades.
Could be. Yeah. Why don't you just take a bite out of them? Gone. Nice big bite.